How much money should I have to get the US visa? What should be my bank balance? What are the investments that I need to show? All of these questions are going to be answered in this video so that you have complete information about the financial aspect of getting the US visa. Keep on watching. Hi guys, my name is Shachi and welcome back to my channel. So I have uploaded a couple of videos on the US visa process. Make sure that you check them out. Something which I get asked very frequently and very, very commonly is, what should be my funding situation or how much funding do I need to get a US visa? Which essentially means that what should be my bank balance to ensure that my visa gets approved? Now, this is something which is very important because poor financial profile is one of the main reasons why visas get rejected. So we are going to be discussing this at length in this particular video. Do keep in mind that all the things that I talk about in this video are applicable only for self-sponsored visas and self-sponsored trips. So let's get started. So let's start with understanding what is the bare minimum balance that you need to show in your bank account, whether it is a saving account or a current account. And for this, first you need to start by estimating the per head cost of your trip. So the cost of your trip will include your flight expenses, your accommodation expenses, and your daily expenses, which will have food, sightseeing, travel, and shopping. Once you have this particular number, multiply this with the number of people who are going for the trip. And this final figure is the minimum amount of money that you need to have in your bank account. So let's say that as per your estimate, the per head cost of your trip is 1.5 lakh rupees. And if you're a family of four who are going for this vacation, then at least 6 to 6.5 lakh rupees should be there in your bank account. This is the minimum balance. Of course, the more liquidity that you can show, the better it is for you. Also, keep in mind that there should be a consistent history of inflow in your account. That means that the money should have got credited steadily over time, something like getting a salary. Any large lump sum of money being transferred or any sudden deposits into your account, especially right before your interview, is going to make the embassy officer suspicious. So try to avoid that completely. Next, let's talk about financial investments, because financial investments also play a very important role in strengthening your financial profile and adding more credibility to your application. So apart from bank balance, if you have investments in other instruments like FD, mutual fund, share certificates, or other long-term investments, then this is going to help you as well. So make an estimate of how much money you have invested in these instruments. What you can do is make a very simple table with the name of the financial instrument on one side and the amount of money that you have invested in that on the other side. So prepare this simple table and carry this document with you when you go for the interview. So if the embassy officer asks you about your financial profile, you can always show this document to him. Of course, make sure that you carry all the relevant proofs and the supporting documents with you for these financial investments. Next, let's talk about other investments. So apart from financial investments, if you have other investments, basically other long-term investments like land, house, or even commercial property, then you can show this in your profile as well. And this will help you because this will do two things for you. One, it will of course strengthen your financial profile and credibility, but it will also support your overall profile because having these long-term investments shows more ties to the home country and shows more reasons to come back to India. So this will definitely help add more credibility to your profile. Lastly, let's talk about the documents that are required. Now here I'm discussing only the documents that are required from the financial aspect of the US visa process. If you want to know a more detailed list of all the documents that you need to take with you, then make sure that you check out my video on the US visa process, because here I discuss in detail all the documents that are required. So coming back to the financial aspect, the documents that you do need to carry for sure and compulsorily are your salary slip, your ITR return, and your bank statement. If you can get your bank statement attested, it'll be better. Apart from this, all the other investments that you show in your profile, whether it's financial or other long-term investments, make sure that you carry the supporting documents and the proofs for all of those. And also make sure that these documents are up to date. So guys, this was the video covering the financial aspect of the US visa process. I hope this has helped you understand how much funding you need to show for a US visa and also what all are the funding patterns that you need to show. If you have any more questions, leave them in the comment section below. Also, do check out my earlier videos on the US visa interview and the US visa process. I'm sure they're going to help you out. If you want more help from me, you can DM me on Instagram. My Instagram handle is right here. You can also book a one-to-one consultation session with me. I will leave the link for this in the description box below. So thank you so much for watching. Do share this video with your friends and family. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button. I'll see you in the next one. Signing off for now. Bye.